Hello friends, in this video let's talk about one of the important concept in SSRS 2016 or 2017. The name of the concept is data driven subscriptions. This is very important for SSRS developer. The concept is very old, even in SSRS 2012 or 2008 or 2008. How to deliver the reports automatically based on particular data. Based on a particular data. Let us say, I have a data which is segregated based on a company. I want to send that particular company data to a particular people. Different company data I want to send to a different people. If you see my earlier example, you will be able to generate entire report. You will be able to send automatically their entire report to a set of people or to a particular location. But here, I am going to send a report based on certain conditions. So let me take you practically to that phase. So let me give a brief background. So what are all the tables which I am planning to use? So here, just to explain, SSRS data driven subscription, I have developed a very basic table. The name of the table is employee. It's a very famous table for everyone. So if you see this, the name of the table is employee. So if you see this, I have around 22 records. So, which contains location, company, department, employee name and salary. So, if you really see this, so I have a different company set of people. So, I have Microsoft, Dell and Oracle. So, there are three companies I have. So, all my employees are segregated across these three companies. So, now I want all Microsoft, like people who works for Microsoft, I want to generate one report. The people who works for a Dell, I want to generate one more report or one more extract. The people who works for Oracle, I want to generate a different extract. So this is my context. So I want three extracts, three copies. So one for Microsoft employees, the other one for Dell employees, the other one for Oracle employees. See, the same report, from the same report, I am generating three copies of report, which is based on the company. So first of all, I need to design a report. So before going to do the design report and all, let me show you what are all the prerequisites you need to be aware of it. First of all, SQL database should be up and running. The database is nothing but the report database as well as your working database. The next one, SQL agent should be up and running. So why? Because it's automatic schedule. So the report subscriptions happens through a SQL agent only. Next one, report server or report manager should be up and running. The next one is report development and deployment. So because I don't want to develop the report now, so I want to show you which is already developed. Next one is data driven subscriptions. So till here, I already did it. I already explained in the previous video how to do it. Next. So now, data driven subscription. So before going to talk about data driven subscription, I'll show you a report which has been developed and deployed in the report manager. It is a one parameter report. Let's come here. So this is my SSRS 2017 report manager window. See, the steps are common across the versions of SSRS, either 2012 or 2016 or 2017. There is no a problem either you are working with 2012 or 2016 or 2017, but here I am showing you with the 2017 interface. So this is a report which I just developed for our example. So which is taking a parameter of please select company Dell. So once you select a Dell, you will get a Dell employees. Once you select Microsoft and click on view report, you will get Microsoft related employees. If you select Oracle and click on view report, you will get Oracle related employees. So here I have three parameters, three values, three companies. and I am able to see the people who belongs to the particular company based on the company. So when you say data driven subscription, it should be a parameterized report. I cannot create a data driven subscription on the top of a normal report. So now let's come back here. So before going to the subscription level, first of all, so I need a query. Why? Because I want to put Dell reports in the Dell folder. I want to put Microsoft report in the Microsoft folder. I want Oracle report in the Oracle folder. This is a shared paths actually. These are shared paths. I want to do a Windows file share data driven subscription. So I just developed, like I just created three folders, individual folders, Dell, Microsoft and Oracle individually. And when I say Dell folder, I need to pass Dell related company. So I need to pass to this parameter Dell value to get a Dell report. For Microsoft, I need to pass Microsoft. For Oracle, I need to pass Oracle. So to do this dynamic, you need to have a one dynamic query with you. So because the value is changing, the path is changing, and file name also you can put it as Dell or Microsoft. That also changes. So to handle that dynamically, I just prepared a query like this. So select, this is the file path. This is the file path for Dell company. File name also I made it as Dell. So this is the file path for Oracle. Company name is Oracle. So this is the file path for Microsoft. This is the file path and the company name also Microsoft. And the file name also here I am making as Microsoft EMPS just to differentiate it. So that it won't give you the confusion. So company, this is a Dell is a company name. File name is Dell employees. File name is Oracle employees. File name is Microsoft employees. So these are the query I just prepared. You need a query or some procedure to execute at that time. Okay, if you run this, you will get like this. Path is this, file name is this, company is this. Just copy this query and keep that ready. Now let's come to the subscription part. So let's go back to the home and folder. And at the right top of the report name, you have three dots. Let's click on the three dots. And please open this report manager in the Internet Explorer only while doing the subscriptions. Because you will get a full support. Full icons visibility. Visibility will be very good when you open the report manager in the Internet Explorer. So let's click on this. Once you click on it, you will get this window. So let's click on manage. So once you click on manage, you will get a window like this. So it will show you like at what time it has been changed, at what time it has been created. And the name is parameter and all. So nothing to worry, nothing to change. So let's come to the data sources first. Here, while running a subscriptions, you need to store the database credentials in the report server itself. That is the reason I made it as use the following credentials. Database username password, Venkat and password is different. Now let's come to the subscriptions. Here, this is the place where we create a subscriptions here. So let's click on new subscription here. So there is no subscriptions as of now. Let's click on new subscriptions. So once you click on new subscription, you will get a window like this. Here the name of the subscription I am making as so EMP data driven or something like that. I can give whatever the name I want. EMP data driven subscription. Owner is my PC name along with user. And the type of subscription. This time I am going with a data driven subscription. So let me select this data driven subscription. So once I select data driven subscriptions, I'll get more options. I'll show you that. And the schedule. So at what time do you want to run it? So at a daily at 2 a.m. of every day, starting from today. I am okay that because I have a manual option to run it also. Next. So destination, at what time do you want to run? So destination delivery, which method you want, either email or Windows file share. As I told you, Windows file share. Windows file share. And I need a data set to pass a dynamic value to the parameter. So that is the reason why I prepared a query, if you remember that. This query is now required. So if you are doing the same activity in 2012, you need to go to the multiple windows, click on next, next, next. But in 2017, you have everything in a single window. So nothing to worry. So there is not much difference. Let's click on edit data set. So here it is asking for shared data source. I do not have any shared data source because it's a very basic report, first report I developed and deployed. Let's click on custom data source for this report. Type is SQL Server. Here provide a connection string as data source equal to /SQL 2016 initial catalog equal to sample, because my query does not require anything, but still I need to provide it. And following credentials as database credentials, as I told you, in my case is this, your case might be different. Okay, here paste the query query and click on validate query, so that the query should be validated successfully, otherwise you cannot. Let's click on apply. Once it is done, now here you need to pass file name. Let's see, these are the three mandatory values and this is the default also. Now here the file name, I am going to get the value from the data set. Get value from data set. Yes, file name should be a file name here. And path, get value from data set, file path, and render format. I can select directly from here. I want in the PDF. Next, here username password. Why username passwords are required here? See, I'm doing a Windows file share. So to connect to this path, I need to pass username and password to my report manager, because report manager does not know which account to use to connect to the particular path. So let me use my account here. Let's enter value directly. So I'm giving my account, administrator account here. PC-Dell. This is my user ID. This is my password. So whatever the password you can give it. And please select the company. Let's get the value from data set. Here the company, which I already given here. So once you are done all these values, let's click on create subscriptions. The good thing is here, everything you are doing in a single window, but in 2012, you have to click on next, 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 and so on. Now the subscription is ready. Hope you know that this subscription runs daily at 2 o'clock in the morning. But do I need to wait till that time to show you the output? I do not need to wait. Let me show you first. Go to this folder and see, it is empty. Every folder is empty now. Yes, it is empty. Let's come here. I want to show you the output. Let's select this and run now. It automatically runs. You can see the status here, running. It is running. So my report is a very basic report. It runs very fast. So you do not need to wait that much time. So let's refresh this IE. Once refresh is done, you can see the status. Done. 3 processed out of 3 total. If you have any errors, you can see 4 errors, 5 errors, something like that. You can see the time, at what time it ran. September 14, 2019, 9:52:31 p.m. So the name is. So again, like tomorrow at early hours of 2 o'clock, again it runs. So let's come to the location and see if the reports are generated or not. Let's refresh this. Go to Dell. Yes, Dell employee file. Name of the file is Dell employees. Click on it. You can see the data here. This is the data you have it. Next, go back to the other folder. Do you see that? Yes, all the employees who belongs to Microsoft, only those people will come here. Next, come here. Again, Oracle, just go here. Yes, the people who belongs to Oracle, you can see the list of people. That's all about data-driven subscriptions. If you really see this, I have generated 3 copies, and those are copies, again, to the specific company, and it went to the specific folders. So that's how data-driven subscription works in SSRS, any version. So that's all about it. So not only this, if you have any question in MSBI, Azure, or Power BI, please don't hesitate to ask. Please drop your question in the comment section. I'll try to answer as soon as possible. Also, follow me on Facebook for more technical updates. That's all about today. So let's meet it in the next video. Thank you. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe for more technical videos.